All right. Here's going to be the Reader's Digest condensed version of how to box model a person. First off, make a box, any box, just throw one in there. Switch over here to your Modify tab. On your Modify tab, name the box Humaniform, and then set the box's length to some numbers that make you happy. For me, I went with 30, 30, and 35 in my original, but I think I'm just going to leave it at 30, 30, 30 and just make it a square for this purpose. I'll just make it a nice little square, 30, 30, 30. Then I want to get my move tool, and I want to make sure, just because Mr. Booth said it's always a good idea, I'm going to start with my artwork centered at the origin, even though during box modeling, that's not that important. Get back on my select object tool. Everything's ready for me to make my first save. You'll be turning in three files on this. Here's one of those files. Save this. And the save will be, I'll put this one over here in demos, Humaniform. But wait, hold on a second. RB, those are my initials. You put your initials. Humaniform. Humaniform. Humaniform, underbar, 001. Because it's my first Humaniform file. So RB Humaniform 001, yours should have your initials, not my initials. I'll click save, got my first file saved. Now I'm going to right click my box here in this window, and I'm going to convert it to an editable poly. When I do that, I now have access to its vertex, edge, border, polygon, and element components. And today, for our purposes, we're going to be messing with polygon, vertex, and just a little bit of edge. So get it set to polygon. Notice that box had a very small menu. Polygon has a very huge menu. This thing goes on forever and ever. There's actually menus here that I've never used before. But let me get back to the very beginning. At least right about here. I like to see that spot where it says zero polygon selected, because that communicates information to me that I'm going to need. It's going to be handy here later. I'm going to orient my scene so that the word front is facing towards the front, so I can see the front of my guy's face right here. And I'm going to select the polygon that's up on the top of their head. Click on bevel, the bevel tool. And the bevel tool is to click. Let me press F4 so I can see my geometry. Click, unclick, and then drag to set the bevel. That's going to make the rounded shape of the top of my head. I'm going to click on the bottom polygon, and I'm going to similarly bevel that one. Extrude it out and bevel it down to something that's the size of a neck. Now that I got it at the size of a neck, I'm going to click on the extrude tool. When I mouse over it now, the extrudes icon's different. I'm going to extrude out a neck. And now I've got my neck. And that was one block of class. Now, second block of class. Ooh, and for, nope, not for you guys, but let's see. You guys actually went a little bit further. We extruded out our shoulders first by making another extrusion, switching to our scale tool, and with our scale tool, in the X axis, scaling it out in the X axis, and in the Y axis, scaling it out in the Y axis. It doesn't get scaled as much in the X as it does in the Y. And that was the end of our first day on this. And this is a good spot to do a file, save as, and hit the plus. Then this is what we did today. So I started with an extrude. I'm going to extrude this out, and this time I'm going to do a little bit of a better job. I'm going to extrude it more than I did the last time, so I've already got that distance built in there. And that's going to set me up for my arms. But then I also want to extrude again to get the rest of my torso. And even though this is a little out of order for some of you, I'll extrude one more time, change to my scale tool, and just scale the whole thing in somewhat. Yeah, good. Scaled it all in. That takes me down to the bottom of my torso. Back on the select object, I'm going to click on that polygon. Swing around to this side. Hold my control key down and select that polygon. I'm going to see that I've got two polygons selected right here. I can also check by Alt key middle mouse buttoned, or I could even use the gizmo here just to check both sides that I got both of those polygons selected. I'm going to select my extrude tool, and I'm going to extrude out the beginning of my arms. So I got the beginning of my arms here. Switch to my select. And I want to get that polygon, press control key, and get that polygon. These two polygons are like under the arms. And with those two polygons selected, I want to extrude again. And I'm going to extrude again about two-thirds of the way down the body. Right-click to end the extrude tool. And I just want to select these one at a time now. That first polygon, press my W key to get the move tool and move that arm out. Select the other polygon. Move that arm out. Just moving these arms out. Then hold control key and select the two polygons and extrude the rest of the arms out down. There we go. Now, before I start to make my legs, I'm going to need to pull a Deadpool on this and slice this whole thing in half. This is where we use the slice plane. So the slice plane's a little bit further down here. You got to go down to Edit Geometry, and you also have to change from polygons to vertex. And on vertex, you're going to find the slice plane. When you click the slice plane, you get this orange plane. It's not oriented properly, though. This plane will cut in vertices and edges at the point wherever you want them when you click a specific button. But first, let's get this facing the right way. I'm going to press my E key to get the rotate tool. And this rotate tool is actually going to rotate my slice plane. Down here in the Y component of this rotate tool, I just want to make it rotate a nice 90 degrees. I type the 90 down there. Hit my Enter key, and that plane is now vertical, straight up and down. My model. That's got all my vertices and edges right where I want them. I'm going to come over here, and this button right under slice plane, there's a button called slice. I'll click that and then turn off the slice plane. And what I see is, hey, I just sliced all these vertices and edges into my model. Now I need to go back to polygons. I want to get these two leg polygons right here. Now in class, I did this using inset. I could also do this using bevel, but then I won't have the chance to show you how to use inset. Also, with inset, I want to use the menu. I don't want to just use the tool, because if I just use the tool, it's only going to do one thing. But if I go to the menu's got choices. And so the menu, right now, by default, it insets by the group. If I were to adjust this inset, I could see how things are changing. But I don't want to adjust it by the group. If I click that spot, it's going to adjust it by polygons. See how it separated them into two different insets? Then I'm going to click the checkbox, and that sets that. And to create something that looks like a bevel, I'll press my W key for my hotkey here, and I'll just pull those two polygons out. And just like that, I created something that looks like a bevel, didn't I? Two bevels. But I used an inset and the move tool. Now, I'm going to extrude out down to my knees. And once I get to my knees, extrude out down to my feet, or my ankles rather. And once I get to my ankles, extrude out one more time, a short distance, because we're going to make our feet out of this part. Right click to end the tool, and I'm going to pick these two polygons on the front of my feet. I'm going to extrude them out so that they're foot-like. Right click to end the tool. Press the R key to get the scale tool and scale from the center. That way it will scale each one down to a nice little kind of pointed foot. And just like that, I box modeled the human body. I could, if I wanted to, maybe even go in here and grab an edge like that, get my move tool, and move that edge out a little bit to give my character a little fatness. And in the back, also move that edge out to give him a little fatness, a little thickness. Oh, and there was one other thing I did too. Front viewport. The shoulders, they're way too pointy on the corners. I'm going to select those two vertices, and by mousing over this little square right here, just move them down into a kind of a nice location that rounds that corner. Select these two vertices and do the same thing. Bring them down to a nice little round corner. How did I know I had two vertices selected? Well, it says it right there. And you know, if I mouse over and select like that, you'll see there's two vertices. You can always check to see what you got selected right there. Then the last thing I did here to wrap this thing up was get back to the editable poly. Nothing selected, no polygon, no vertex, just the editable poly. And on the modifier list, I type TU, and it's like, do you want turbo smooth? I want turbo smooth. And that slaps a turbo smooth modifier on that bad boy. And that's a good looking humaniform right there. I could bump the iterations up to 2 just to give me some more detail, but otherwise pretty happy with that. And I can always get back to my original editable poly there in the stack. This is called the stack. This is a good place to do another save as, and I'll hit the plus key. I've now got a humaniform file 001, 002, and 003. And that's the very bare minimum of what you should have. Please submit your work. Don't forget to like and subscribe. Yeah, that's right. You got to subscribe. You know you want to subscribe.